Mike Elgin V from Modern Day Fitzgerald. This is Joe. How do you say last name?
Stanzioli.
Stanzioli? Mm.
That was off. Stanziola.
Oh. We're gonna talk about songwriting and heartbreak and shit. Where'd you get the name Secondhand King from?
I got it from a Brian Hyland song called The Joker Went Wild. And it's really, it doesn't say Secondhand King, but it's like, when I was a king, I thought always a king. It's like about thinking you know everything and you don't.
God, that's actually really dope. Frankie is one of my top favorite albums so far this year.
Thank you.
I'm not just saying that.
I can tell when you're just saying that, and you know, I can tell you're not just saying that.
Please.
Which is beautiful. Thank you.
You're beautiful. Because every other like album like I've been listening to, like everyone's been going away from like actual concepts. Mm-hmm. So Frankie does a very good job of like going through an actual story itself too. Reminds me of like American Gangster with Jay-Z's American Gangster. It has like a little storyline going.
Thank you.
Before we even talk about anything, I was like, what's the overall interpretation concept of Frankie itself?
I guess Frankie for me, like I do this weird thing where I just sort of write and then I figure out what it means.
Same.
Later. Yeah. Like maybe a month or 2 months or 4 months later, I'll figure out. And I feel like Frankie, and I say that because every day, like I'm like figuring out really what it means. And Frankie, I think, has like, there's like a fantasy. I don't want to give it away.
No.
You just listen to the album. You listen to it. It means something different for me than it means to you.
It means something different for everybody else. I totally get it. Because I saw your interview with Stephen Irway. You were talking about, like, you know, how, like, you had a particular heartbreak itself, too, that kind of helped influence this album or, like, most songs that you have been writing so far.
Mm.
I guess, what about that particular heartbreak gets you where it's, like, you need to, like, write it down for your lyrics?
Well, I feel like that one in general was a very, like, I just jumped all the way in.
Yeah.
And I am not really prone to do that. So when I jumped all the way in, it was like, holy shit, there's a lot of things about me that I've been avoiding.
Yeah.
And at the same time, too, you know, I really wanted it to work. Because when you give somebody a ring, you think that it's gonna last.
Yeah. No. I totally get it.
And it, when it doesn't, you're just like, oh, okay. And I think for me, it was like, this is something I created, and this is something that I needed to understand, I think. I think that's what really bothered me and why I felt like I needed to write so many songs about it was I just didn't understand. I think Frankie is like trying to find that depth in yourself. And maybe, I don't know.
No, it's like, it's funny, it's like, you know, with most musicians, there's always a couple songs about heartbreak, because it's like, it fucks you up.
Well, I feel like it's somewhat of a musician's job just to talk about this shit that, like, it's one thing to write about heartbreak, but it's another thing to write, like the depth of heartbreak, like the reality of it, the stuff that, like, is uncomfortable to talk about in real life. Because that's just how it is.
Yeah. Because with, you know, with most pop songs, like pop artists, whatever, and when they talk about heartbreaks, like, you know, Bruno Mars, Dancing with Another Man or something like that. Like, it's just like most pop artists, they always, like, go, like, the ice, just, like, the little small nippets of, like
well, the actual level.
The surface level, like, you know, it's like, oh, you're not with me anymore. Sad, but actually getting down to the nitty-gritty parts of it, like, for example, I have a particular song called Forsaken Echo. It's basically about, like, looking through the past. Like, I have, my biggest problem is I always look towards the past rather than the future. I always go back to a particular moment, like, if I hear a sound or a smell or something.
Well, maybe there's, like, see that, I relate to that a lot. I mean, I think everybody does that. I don't think that's, like, a...
It's not a bad thing. It's like,
it is a bad thing, but
go for it, please.
I feel like we are, as humans, a lot smarter than we give ourselves credit for. So I think when you're in the past, you're really trying to learn about something. You're really trying to, like, get to understand something.
Yeah.
And that's exactly where I am, because I still think about this person that there's no reason to.
No.
And I think it's a lesson. I don't think it's... I think a lot of people say, like, well, you're just meant to be with that person, or it's love. But sometimes it's just like, I just need to learn a fucking lesson. Well, it's like they never warn you about that. No. You're in a relationship. Like, there's restaurants that are just normal restaurants. They're just buildings with food. But I have this, like, emotional attachment to them that I can't walk into them. You know, I can't. There's a coffee shop in the world that I love their coffee, but I can't go into.
Yeah.
And it's just further proof that humans in general are emotional beings. And that's a good thing.
Yeah.
And that's how we should be. But I feel like we need to. I feel like it's our opportunity to try to better understand what this whole human existence is.
Agreed.